Now, this is very interesting because a lot of people worry. They say these are lovely human beings, lovely. They are God people, God man, really. Why do they suffer? People like us, we understand we may have done some mischief, so we can pay a price for it, and we get thumped here and there. But these people have done no mischief, and by the very likely in the past life they have not done any mischief. And yet, why do they have, you know, cancer? Both Ramakrishna had cancer, Ramana Maharshi had cancer, and Vivekananda, when he passed, they discovered he had 20 illnesses undiagnosed. He didn't bother, he didn't tell anybody. He had these severe problems, and yet he kind of lived his life fully without making a single complaint about his bodily functions. Never. This is why, this are, you say, but Mr. Lakhani, why do they suffer? Let me tell you the answer. They don't suffer. You say, you saw them, the cancer. Look, these people are beyond the idea they are the body. It's not just make believe, they actually don't feel they are the body. They would struggle to get back into the body. So for them, these physical illnesses are not real. I'll give you one interesting example. You see, this Ramakrishna, as I tell you, had a habit of, if you mention, this is the unique feature of this particular God-man. If you mention the word God, religion, spiritual, anything, he goes into deepest meditation, whether he's standing or sitting or whatever, goes in, difficult to bring him down. We fight to get out of the ego, he fights to get back in the ego. This was a real story of the person in our lifetime, in our times. So he had difficulty. And while he was like this, is the habit, while he's walking, somebody mentions God, he goes into deep meditation, he topples over, he broke his arm. So they put a bandage, and he's wondering about with a bandage. And he was just making, you know, someone, they were a little devotee, came and said, pain. And the devotee said, you don't have pain, do you? And Ramakrishna smiles, you rascal, you caught me out. I'm just making a pretend. Oh, I'm human, I got pain. He says, I don't feel, there's no such thing. Remember, they don't suffer for it. They are in full flow of the true nature of the spirit. How can they have physical, you know, kind of problems, kind of bothering them? That's what Vivekananda had. 20 problems, nobody knew about it. He didn't bother with it either. He just flies through it, flies through. This is the outer garment. So he just kind of play with it, feed it, etc. But they don't get caught up by it. So they're not they don't suffer. Remember, my friend, they don't suffer. Because people say, oh, you see, I went as a little child, my mom used to take me all these, you know, devotional movies or Hindi devotional movies where the devotees suffer. They get leprosy and the mother go, ah. And I said, I don't want to be a devotee. The poor devotees have to go through hell like this. This is terrible. In reality, a true person established in God experience does not suffer. The beautiful story of Narasimha Mehta, as you may have heard, but never mind, I won't go into that.
Free e-learning course in Hinduism. To register, please visit www.hindu-academy.com.
Talks on Hinduism. Sponsored by People Care. Encouraging caring for the elderly in their own homes. For more information, please visit peoplecare.com.